By the end of this video, you'll know exactly what an AI agent is, how you can use it to save hours of work every week, and stick around till the end because I will walk you through how to set up your very first AI agents yourself. No code, just a few minutes of your time, that's all you need. Hey, I'm Remi, I've been a software engineer for 15 years, and I now run an AI automation agency. In short, I build AI agents for a living. And let me tell you, most videos that try to explain AI agents are extremely confusing and not realistic. Today, we're breaking down AI agents so simply that even your coffee machine could get it. So what is an AI agent? If you've searched AI agents on YouTube or Google, chances are you hit a wall of technical jargon. It's like learning how to drive by looking at what's under the hood. But here's a simple analogy for you. An AI agent is like a super efficient intern that is also your assistant. You give it a goal, a few tools, and some instructions, and it just gets to work. Technically, it takes three things to make an AI agent. It must be a smart bot that can think a little, remember a little, and take an action. It reads something, figures out what needs to be done, and actually does it. AI agents are changing the game because they can take over all the boring parts of your job while you can focus on the most interesting pieces. Here are some examples of how companies use it. For example, in marketing, it's being used for content repurposing or trend analysis, or even campaign summary, just pulling a lot of data and clarifying it. In sales, it's used for lead qualification, follow-up, and CRM cleanup. For HR, it could be for onboarding, for policy FAQ for internal policies, for example. There's many, many more cases, and every company uses it completely differently based on their use cases, but possibilities are endless. So here are the three steps in order to build your first AI agent. It's actually exactly like hiring an employee. You need to think of it as, I first need to hire, then you need to onboard, and then I need to improve and make that employee better. In this case, that's sort of the platform, the automation platform that you want to be using. It could be N8N, it could be make.com, it could be Zapier. Google is launching its own agent space very soon. That's a very important piece because it will be really important because it will impact exactly how smart you want it to be. That will integrate with your ecosystem and what tool you can talk to, and really the power of it. Do you need something that just can talk to Google Sheets and that's it? Or do you want someone that has experience in 50 different tools that you're using, right? So you need to really think about that first. Then a really big part of the hiring is also the brain. Well, you need to figure that out, what kind of brain you want. And there's a lot out there that's called the model in this case. Think of OpenAI, Claude, Gemini, etc. And then the memory, not something you typically focus on with hiring a human, but this is an important one with an AI agent. How big do you want the memory? Do you want someone with a very small memory, or do you want someone with a ton of experience, a ton of data, and ton of capacity to ingest big data? So whether you're hiring a human or an AI agent, the tougher the job, the harder it is to find the right fit. Now, the big difference is hiring an AI agent takes a few days at most, not a few months. Try doing that with people. In our example today, you'll see it only takes a few minutes to build your very first one, but in some cases, it can be a lot more complex. Now, when you're done with the hiring phase, you want to go into onboarding. You need to give the new hire a set of instructions. In this case, this is a prompt. You want to hook them up with different tools like an email, Slack, Google Sheets, CRM. Whatever tool you're using, you need to integrate that to the AI agent. That's the exact same process for humans as for an AI agent. And then you kind of walk them through exactly what is the input when you receive a specific message or email and what they should be doing, how they should be responding to the customers. This is how we do things here. And then last is the performance tweaks. Once you have that employee up and running, you still want to regularly review their performance to see how they're doing, tighten the instructions, update your documentation, add access to more data, more tools, make sure that you always have the best process that is the most optimized. Also track where you're saving your time or messing up and adjust. So now you hire the perfect AI agent. Now it takes seconds to hire three more like them and scale your customer service. So here is a real world example. Let's say you work in support or marketing or security, and you're constantly replying to the same questions. Instead of doing it manually, you set up an AI agent that reads the requests, find the answers in the documentation, and replies. This is exactly what I'm going to walk you through today.